Hi, my name is Greg, and in this three-part series, you will learn a few tips for how to create memory-efficient process models, which can be helpful when developing process models for any use case. In this video, you will learn about the positive impacts to process memory by keeping your processes short-lived. Be sure to like, subscribe, and comment to see more videos like this one, and don't forget to check out our other great courses in the Advanced Process Model Learning Path on Academy Online. You can also check out Introduction to Autoscale. Autoscale can dynamically adjust process execution capacity based on demand, providing memory-efficient processes without any additional configuration. Get links to these and other relevant resources linked in the description below. Throughout the series, we will look back at this example process model that has several areas of opportunity to improve memory efficiency. Notice the number of nodes, user input tasks, timers, and quick task process flows. This process represents an HR new employee onboarding workflow and covers the entire 6-month process from the offer letter to when they are offered a permanent position. Compare that process model to this one with the same workflow. Notice the reduction in nodes, condensed user input tasks, and the use of subprocesses. Let's explore some tips on how you can achieve a memory-efficient process design by redesigning this process even further. Before we get into the first tip, let's talk about what process memory is. At a high level, process memory is dedicated memory used to support Appian processes. Process variables and other process data store in process memory throughout the life of the process, at which point data management policies kick in. In process properties, you can set how a process should handle process memory after a process has successfully completed or has been canceled. If the process is in memory, it is available for reporting, which can be helpful when you want to show process information on an interface or access specific analytics. For example, if stakeholders want to know on average how long certain user tasks are taking to complete. If the process has been archived, it is only available to developers to use for troubleshooting from the Process Activity tab in the Monitor view in Appian Designer. If you will not need to display reporting data to your users, set your process to archive process data to 0 or within a few days after successfully completing or canceling the process. A good rule of thumb is, if you do not need to keep it, archive it, or even better, delete it. Keep in mind, the number of days you set can have a large impact on memory with larger, higher volume processes. But what considerations should you make for a process that's currently running? Let's check out our first tip. Tip number one, design your processes to be short-lived. In our process, we are onboarding a new employee. Notice how there are several steps, user input tasks, and sub-processes that support the entire onboarding workflow from end to end. Let's look at how we can change this process so it can be more memory efficient by combining multiple user input tasks into a multi-step form or breaking out user input tasks into separate record actions. Notice there are a couple process flows that we can immediately split into separate processes as record actions. There is also a timer start node that is set to wait for scheduled arrival, so we can split this part of the process out and have it execute when the employee arrives. Splitting processes out ensures that each process focuses on one specific step in the workflow and ensures the process ends as quickly as possible, freeing up process memory to be available for other processes. Also notice there are several user input tasks that are specific to HR responsibilities. If these represent tasks to be completed by the same individual, they can be condensed into a single, multi-step form. Check out design.appian.com to learn more about creating multi-step forms using SAIL. Beyond the better user experience of completing a single task, rather than several tasks, each user input task instance is saved in the process history. The more instances saved in the process history, the larger the process memory footprint. Alternatively, if each user input task is being completed by a different user, consider how long this process would take to complete if the workflow is waiting for each user to complete their task. If the process is alive, it's using process memory. Instead, consider splitting the processes into smaller, contextual processes. If the next step in the workflow requires a specific individual to complete the task, consider using record actions to kick off the next step, rather than a user input task. This ensures that no process is running for longer than it needs to, and is only executed when the user is ready to complete the next step in the workflow. And that's it! Be sure to check out the next video, Create Memory Efficient Processes in Appian, tip number 2, and explore how process variables and activity class parameters can be configured to improve process memory. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.